Hello, Gundam fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the 144 high-grade Ag Zaku Kycillia forces from Gundam the Origin. So yeah, another Zaku based on the Zaku 2, but man, this thing is way different. There are so many pieces that are completely new on this. Like, I'm hard-pressed to think of ones that are actually reused from the Zaku 2. The backpack, pretty sure. Maybe the back skirt. I don't even think the thighs or the upper arms are. I'm pretty sure everything is basically new. Like, well, not everything, but almost everything. And I gotta say, I love the design. Let's get a good look on this thing. Like, the head is cool looking. It's got the little snout, but then some extra detail here. The chest is really cool. I love that chest. Very different. Extra detail that pokes through from the plastic inside. The skirt's different. Back skirt, like I said, might be the same. The legs are cool. And hey, I don't think there's any seam lines. I think they're all panel lines. Even the arms, they friggin' did it. It's a panel line, not a seam line. Finally. Same thing with the back of the leg here. Pretty sure that is a panel line. Yes, I think the shield's the same as before, but I mean, and the shoulder armor probably the same. Still nicely detailed. But man, this thing looks amazing. I really like it. For a Zaku, like, even the Zaku 2 variant, it's different enough. It has the same head crest as the Kycillia Zaku 1, so you know it's for her forces. It's as solid as Zaku 2, because like, a lot of the inner parts are the same. And the stickers, you got the eye, the mono eye there. And then you do have, it's a nice enough size sticker sheet with a lot of numbers on it. A little bit of a marking stickers. Some symbols. So yeah, I never thought I'd say I'm really loving a Zaku 2 after having so many in the last few years. But this one is really cool. And so since a lot of the inner parts are the original Zaku 2 Origin, articulation is pretty much the same. Head does rotate. Head does move forward and back. Whoops. Now this is one thing I gotta complain about. This new setup for the head. I would suggest gluing it, if you're gonna articulate the head up and down. It rotates fine enough. See, what they try to do, they did it successfully, and it does work. They made it so that the eye moves. It's geared, so it moves with the when you rotate the head. It's not perfect, but it does work. And though the way they had to do it, the way it pegs in here, it's not hard to come unpegged. Although it's not loose, so it's not terrible. Just I wanted to point that out. It does come off a little easier than I'd like. But for having the rotating mono eye, I'm not going to complain too much. And then the arms can go up at the polycap on the torso. They're ball jointed. So they go all the way around. You got the double hinge shoulder armor. So the arm can go that far out. And then the ball jointed and hinge shield. So the arm can go the same. Rotate below the shoulder. Double jointed elbow. Ball jointed wrist. You've got the nice ball jointed waist, even though the hosing is now connected to the skirts. It's a side skirt, does not the front. So it gives you enough give. So it's still fairly decent. The front skirts are together. I'm pretty sure you can separate them. Hinge side skirt. No, they're ball jointed, just like the other ones. But the only, you can see it in there, it does have that track, so you can push it back if you want. And I like how it kind of looks like the whole basket is one section. It conforms nicely. And then you have that hinge of the legs go forward at the crotch. So legs can go that far forward, and back, and out. Rotate the thigh. Nice double jointed knee, just like before. And you have the hinge, and then the ball joint. This is a really weird. Can I pull this out and show you? This is a new setup. So you have the, like, the polycap in there, so you have the rotation. And it also is hinged in there. And then you have the actual hinge in the ankle. And then it's painted into the front of the foot, so you have ankle tilt. Well, these are different, and they're very cool. And you can barely tell that they're because of the ankle armor that wraps around. And the ankle armor actually pegs kind of into the back, so the side parts are just kind of sitting there, which is good. It gives you some leeway, so you can have a wider stance without the ankle armor popping off. Not super wide, but wide enough for a Zaku. So yeah, this articulation is also very good, I have to say. Well, since this is a Zaku 2, based on a Zaku 2, what will we be without the prerequisite Heat Hawks? So we got the stored version, the used version, which is always the same with the way you hold them. And you can peg this onto the skirt if you want. Just like the other ones. Whatever. But really, who needs these baby ones when you have these two new large Heat Hawks? These are so cool. I love the design of the axes. I like everything about them, how they're curved a little bit. Very nice. They're nice and large. I mean, in comparison to the original Heat Hawk. Friggin' baby. Oh wait, here's the extended one. It's a baby. So they're very cool. Now, you can't quite get them into the hands, so you do have to take the hands apart in order to do it. I mean, it's not a big deal, really. Won't be the first time, won't be the last time. And the handles are fairly large, so there's really no give when you have them in the hand. So, that's cool. And another thing, they give you a mounting clip for each one. So you can put them on the skirts. So basically, clips onto this bar closest to the blade, and then pegs onto the side for storage. And that's pretty cool. I do like that. And you also have an open left hand. And then another really cool accessory, which is new. This thing. This thing is called, if I'm reading the instructions properly, the quadruple mount machine gun. That's pretty crazy. It looks like they took the hand from a gun cannon, and then a gun tank, and just kind of fashioned it around a gun. Pretty cool. Got the handle. I don't really like the handle, just because it doesn't like go flush against the gun. It's a weird design. I mean, you can still hold it in a hand, but it's really weird. And the stock is kind of weird as well. But I do like it. And the trigger finger hand is angled at the ball joint, so it fits naturally into the hand. And it does look pretty cool. So this means you can have all of its weaponry on it, because you can have this on the other side skirt, because you have another clip. So you can do that if you want. Let me take that hand apart and clip it on there. There we go. And if you really want, you can have the other Heat Hawk in this hand, but I don't, because I don't really like it compared to these ones. So yeah, I really like the accessories. These new ones, these large Heat Hawks, and this quadruple machine gun are very cool. So let's show this next to a Gundam, the local type. And then how about the Gundam head from Thunderbolt. So you can see how they look compared to them. And then how about the Zaku 2 half cannon. So if I stand them straight, let me get this guy. I think the Akazaku is just a teeny... No, actually, it might be the same height. I think it might be the little detail in the head that makes it look like it's taller, but I think it's the same height. But just look at a normal Zaku 2 Origin, mostly, compared to the Akazaku, everything is different. thighs, legs, skirts, feet, chest. Like I said, I think the shoulder armor is the same, the shield's the same. The back skirt. Yeah, it looks the same. Backpack. Obviously not in here, but on a normal one. So, yeah. And then, finally, because this is Kycillia's forces, here is the Zaku 1 Kycillia forces. You can see they share the color scheme. Kind of hope they give us another one. Another Zaku variant, Kycillia forces, just to have a trio. That'd be nice. So, that is the high-grade Axe Zaku Kycillia's forces, and I really love it. Man, it's so nice to have a fresh Zaku. That doesn't just have, like, a few extra pieces, it's, like, almost everything is new. And it all works, and it looks good. Like, I am glad they tried to do the movable eye gimmick with the neck, like a master grade. And like I said, it's not perfect, because the way the head connects. But it's not really that bad. And the weapons are good, the articulation's good, it just is overall a great Zaku. So that's about it, and I'll see you in the next review.